Today, we are going to study one of the most puzzling, difficult and multifaceted remedy, the Kalis of homeopathic materia medica. Kent says this is a hard remedy to study. It is not used as often it should be used, and the reason is it is confusing and complex remedy, mainly because the patients withhold their symptoms and give vague symptoms. The best way to understand such a remedy or a patient is by understanding its key elements in terms of its general features, modalities, sphere of actions, thermals, and lastly the mental symptoms. They are oversensitive people. There is a sensitivity to being touched, tickled easily. They don't allow people to touch their souls. There is easy startling from noise or touch. Their sleep is disturbed and wakes up from slightest noise and often gives a jerky reaction. They are sensitive to the every change in atmosphere, sensitive to slightest draft of air, at times getting up at night and checking where is the draft coming from. Another characteristic and key feature of Kali is 2 to 4 a.m. aggravation. Whenever in a case this feature comes up, then this remedy must be considered strongly. Let us see some specific aggravation times of different Kalis. Kali Ars and Kali Bichrome, midnight or 1 a.m. aggravation. Kali Carb, 2 to 4 a.m. aggravation. Kali Nitricum, Kali Sulf, 3 a.m. aggravation. Kali Iode, 5 a.m. aggravation. Sinus troubles of Kalis are almost legendary and run through all the Kali salts. Swelling around the eyes. Kali Carb has swelling around the eyes, but under the eyes most Kalis have it. This feature is important to understand because, as you have seen, Kent has said in the beginning that these patients have a tendency to withhold their symptoms. So physical observations become very important when we are understanding a Kali personality. If you come across a patient who has swelling under the eyes and that swelling has got nothing to do with his pathology, then you should consider a Kali element if the other points of the case fit in. Another strong area of affection is the epigastrium. Everything that happens in Kali, any kind of an excitement or a news or a bad news, have a tendency to be affected at the epigastrium. Respiratory affections like asthmas and pneumonias, Kali salts are most important. It would be interesting for you all to just go to Alan's keynote and see what Hanuman writes about Kali Carb about respiratory affections. And lastly, arthritis runs strongly through all of them. Usually, Kalis are chilly except Kali Iode and Kali Sulf. Kali Ars, Kali Bichrome, Kali Carb are chilliest. Kali Foss is in between chilly and hot. Kali Nitricum, Kali Sulf and Kali Iode are hot. These people are 9-to-5 job type people, working in the same company for years without change. Their life is routine and they don't like to have any changes in their routine. They are very principled and practical people. They don't think emotionally. They are more rational, logical, and take decisions from their mind. The entire life goes in thinking about the family. They are anxious about the family. Something happening to the family members can freak them out. This anxiety stems from the dependence on family members. At the same time, these people are quarrelsome with family members. There are arguments with the family members. So, the Kali is a peculiar combination of anxiety, dependence, and quarrelsomeness with the family. Sometimes the physician is also a part of this family. So, the patient is dependent, anxious, and quarrelsome with the physician as well. The aspect of quarrelsomeness differentiates Kali from calcarea. Because calcarea is also anxious, dependent and family oriented, thinks about job, money, routine, security. But they are not quarrelsome like the Kalis. So, a person who is very routinist, duty bound, anxious, dependent, and at the same time quarrelsome with family members, with the sinus affections, respiratory system, or the arthritic pains, with characteristic swelling under the eyes, and typical 2 to 4 m aggravation, should make one think of a Kali salt. Given the polycrest nature of the remedy, there are many aspects to Kali. But from my experience, what has worked and what I have seen working clinically in practice is what I have penned down. Thank you for your time and attention. Until then, see you next time.